T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 3, 2, 1, 0, and liftoff.
You know, I often get asked how I got interested in space. Is this something that happened as a childhood dream? And yeah, in a sense, you know, when I was growing up as a young child, it was actually, I'm old enough, that was before Sputnik, before any humans had been in space. I was in New York City. My dad used to take me to the planetarium all the time. He was kind of interested in astronomy, and I don't know what it was that clicked, but there was just something about space. It represented the future. I mean, the public media at those times, mostly, of course, newspapers, magazines, televisions, they were full of stories about the coming space age. So it was just really exciting.
Mission specialist Jeff Hoffman.
Jeff was the first astronaut to log more than 1,000 hours aboard the Space Shuttle. He made 5 Space Shuttle missions, including the first mission to repair the Hubble Space Telescope.
3, 2, 1, drop.
Here at MIT, Jeff is a fabulous educator.
Oh, it was good until it
collapsed. Very active in teaching both undergraduate and graduate classes in the Department of Aeronautics and Astronautics. In fact, Jeff teaches 1600, our freshman introductory aerospace class, which is what 1600X was in part based on.
Revolution in online education, creating the MITx program, which feeds material into the edX platform. And we decided that this introductory course would be a good thing to share with a much wider audience throughout the world. So 1600 became 1600X.
1600X is unique in that it's a technical course, but it's also available to the general public. So we try to present complex topics in a way that is very accessible to everyone, even those without a technical background. And I think that's what really contributed to the appeal and popularity of this course worldwide, because there are so many people who are very interested in spaceflight but thought, you know, it would take so much engineering education for me to even begin to understand what that's all about. But we've actually tried to make the course as accessible as possible so that students can still get the basic ideas of what astronautics and human spaceflight is all about without having gone through an engineering education.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It's not a trivial task putting on an online course. It takes a lot of personnel in making the course in the first place. We had people looking after the video, to actually do the video filming, and of course before that I had to write out scripts that were much more, I think, extensive and detailed than when I'm talking in class, because you really have to tailor the lectures to an online audience with which you don't have direct give and take contact. When I'm talking in class, I can look at the students, I can look at their eyes, I can see, are they paying more attention to reading their email on their computers, or are they paying attention to me? That direct face-to-face interaction you don't get. I'm talking to a TV camera right now, and that's how I have to give my lectures. And I'm pretty used to talking to cameras, so I can do it. I can treat the camera almost as a person, but you don't get that direct feedback. And so we have to structure the course so that I give my lectures, and then we try to make problem sets and in that way try to gauge whether the online students are actually getting the material. And I'm delighted, it seems to have been very popular, and we've got a lot of really, really nice feedback.
Do you have any feedback for the course facilitators?
Well, I'd like to say that the fact that the lectures were so well explained and engaging may be the reason why I was so successful in this course.
So it was a very interesting class, I enjoyed it a lot, and I'm proud to have been associated with it. Thank you.
You know, MIT is a distant dream, but you guys help us make that dream come true, so give us more and more of MIT experience. Thank you.
One of the biggest strengths about 1600X is that we had an enormous and very diverse student population. We had over 12,000 students enrolled online, and they come from almost 150 different countries. And this led to one of the challenges with the course as well, because students coming from so many different backgrounds, we had to make sure they were all on the same page.
And it's really exciting to see so many of these things coming together, the people, the technologies, the ideas, the passion for education, culminating in something like 1600X and really extending MIT's reach to have global impact.
It's just the topic. I mean, spaceflight is something that a lot of people are interested in, but they don't really know much about it. And having the opportunity to learn about it for free from an astronaut, who's a professor at MIT, that is just such an incredible and unique opportunity that really would only exist in the online community.
I think it does indicate that there are real changes going on in education, and we have yet to figure out how online courses are ultimately going to change public education, but we know enough now to know that exciting things are happening, and it was great being a part of this in the early days of online learning with 1600X. Don't lose sight of the big picture. Remember that the reason you became an aerospace engineer was because you dreamed of flight.
A new era of American space exploration.
Never, never forget your dreams.